Hallelujah. 60 years of liberation of Goa. All we can say is we can give thanks to God Almighty. I thank God for this beautiful state of Goa. You know, Goa is the tiny state of India. And may Goa be blessed beyond measures, and may it be blessed with all that God has in plan. Amen. The Bible says in James 1, verse 17, every good and perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of the heavenly lights, who does not change like shifting shadows. Amen. Every good and perfect gift is from God. And God has blessed us with the land of Goa, with all the blessings upon it. And I want to tell you that freedom is particularly so precious for everyone. 60 years back, we see Goa was in colonial rule. But today, when we look back, we can say that unless the Lord builds, the builders build in vain. Every nation, every territory, every zone, you know, it belongs to the Lord, and we are His people. You know, God is our God, and this land belongs to Him, and we are His people, the people chosen by God. And I want to go back to the story in the Bible. Years back in the Bible, the story we see in the Old Testament, you know, the Israelites lived in bondage of the Egyptians. They were living in slavery. They were living in bondage, and they did not know the true meaning of freedom. And Israel was subjected to slavery, bondage under the Egyptian rule. But the Bible tells us that God heard their misery. God heard the cry of the Israelites, crying upon God to deliver them out of that slavery, out of that yoke of bondage. And He was preparing a deliverer, and that was Moses, to lead the people out of the slavery from Egypt into the promised land. And God wanted to, you know, His destination was from a place of yoke, of bondage, to a place of freedom, that is the promised land. God wanted to give them a place of authority, a place of freedom, a place once again where they could, you know, communicate and have a relationship with all the freedom that God had prepared already for them. And God used Moses for the deliverance of the Israelites. And we see God is interested in people living in freedom completely, so that man can enjoy that relationship. So that was what God had created man for. Amen. And we see that in the book of Genesis, in the first book of the Bible, even in the Garden of Eden, God had given Adam and Eve that authority, and He wanted Adam and Eve to exercise that authority, to live in dominion and to take authority upon this whole earth, and to, you know, exercise His authority and know that, you know, He is not subjected to any slavery, but He can experience that true freedom and a relationship with God. But what happened, we see Adam and Eve, man chose to live under that fear and under that slavery of sin. They fell down, they chose sin. And God's idea is to bring people out of the slavery, out of the bondages of sin and darkness, and to give them a shackle-free life, that is to live in freedom. That is the true freedom, to live and to know and to recognize who God is, and also to make people know who the real God is. Amen. But it is us, you, me, all of us, we have this struggle and, you know, our constant battle with sin. It is man who is battling with sin every day, in and out, trying to, you know, escape this temporary kind of hurdles, and man tries to fall in the shackles of sin, not knowing, you know, who can deliver them out of these bondages. But Apostle Paul cries out, and we can identify with him. In the book of Romans, you know, Paul says, "Wretched man that I am, who can rescue me? Who can save me? But thanks be to God, it is through Christ Jesus, you know, I can find that freedom. You know, God can rescue me because of Christ Jesus." And that's what I want to say. Just like Apostle Paul, you know, we can say, "Oh, we are so wretched. We fall down. You know, we are broken. We are out in these bondages of sin, of shackles, of death, of hopelessness. Who can rescue us? But thanks be to God, it is because of Christ Jesus we can find that freedom that no man can give us. But it is through Christ Jesus when we can experience the spiritual freedom." Amen. And on this Liberation Day of Goa, as we celebrate, I want to speak to you and tell you that God has given us a responsibility. Amen. He has given us a responsibility to take charge so that we can rescue people out of the darkness, out of those bondages, out of the shackles. And we have a great, huge responsibility which is given to us by the Father in heaven. Amen. He has sent Jesus, his Son, to rescue us from the dominion of darkness. And he has made the way for us to approach the Father anytime, any day, 24/7. We can approach our God, the Father. And he has entrusted us the responsibility to bring people out of darkness into the light. And many a times we see the enemy of hopelessness engulfs us. What is this enemy that is trying to engulf the people? There's so many things that is engulfing the people. The enemy of depression, the enemy of sickness, the enemy of hatred, the enemy of ego, the enemy that is want to do his own thing. All this kind of shackles is trying to engulf the people and make them, you know, in a depressed, and make them go into bondages of slavery of sin. But I want to say, thanks be to God, through Christ Jesus, we can experience the true freedom in Christ. And God has given us that authority. The Bible says, "Those who call upon the name of the Lord, they shall be saved." Amen. And when we call upon the name of the Lord, you may be going through the dark phases of your lives, in this kind of, you know, depression, hopelessness, not knowing where your answer comes from. But I want to say, call upon the name of the Lord. Those who call upon the name of the Lord Jesus, the Bible says, they shall be saved. Hallelujah. And that exactly, I want to say, we can identify with Apostle Paul, his words. It says, we can, you know, nobody can save us, wretched men that we are, but it is through Christ Jesus. I want to tell you that when you are in Christ, you know, distractions may torture us. And, you know, sometimes all this kind of distraction which comes in our lives, like distractions of negativity, distractions of failure, distractions that comes us that we want to look out for human approval, all kind of things can bog down us, and we might feel that we are going down and down. But I want to tell you that all these things that we are going through, we need to get liberated from these thoughts and that sin that so easily comes in our life. Amen. I want to read a scripture. It says in Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1. It says, "Therefore, since we are surrounded by such great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangles us. Let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us. Verse 2, let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith. Amen. Many a times we see the sin that so easily entangles us, and then we try to focus on all the temporary thing that, you know, entangles us, and we forget that we need to look ahead, to look to Jesus and the great cloud of witnesses that has surrounded, which has gone past, and people of God who have worked for the, you know, for giving for the work of the Lord, which has gone by, and we forget to look at their faith. And this day I want to challenge you, as we know that Goa has been liberated from the colonial rule, but we need to understand that there is some things, the sin that so easily entangles us, we need to get liberated from that. And it is a daily process. Hallelujah. We need to work on our lives and tell the Lord, Lord, I need you. I need to focus on God this day. Every day in my life, I want to understand that nothing of mine will work, but it is through the Spirit of God that I can take authority over the situations, over the sinful areas, over the thought life that I'm going through, over the bad things that I'm going through, over the bad thoughts that I think, over the things that I, what I want to do, the bad deeds that I want to do. I want to be an overcomer in those areas. And every, all those things that we encounter every day of our life, I want to say, let us fix our eyes upon Jesus, who is the author and the perfecter of our faith. And as the Lord had purposed a great plan when the Israelites were delivered out of the Egypt, out of the bondage of slavery and darkness, through the help, you know, God raised a leader, Moses, and they were delivered. And we see God had a great plan for the land of Israel. And the same thing I want to tell you, that God in His mercy, and God has a great plan for the land of Goa. You and me and all of us, as we dwell in this land, let the purposes of God be met in the land. Amen. Because everything belongs to God. This is His land. Everything belongs, all that He has created belongs to the Lord. And when we have been given a freedom from the colonial rule in this land of Goa, let us thank God. Let us be grateful. God, thank you so much for liberating this land of Goa from the colonial rule. And we want to thank you. We accept this land of Goa. And we thank you, Lord, for giving us this great and beautiful land. Help each one of us to fulfill the great plan and the destiny of God that God has for us in this land of Goa. Amen. Let the plans of God and the purposes of God be fulfilled through you and me for this generation and the coming generation in this land. Let the glory of the Lord come upon this land. And as we are the vessels, God is looking out for you and me. We are the vessels, and God has chosen us. We are the true vessels, and God needs His hands, His mouth. He wants to pour out His Spirit upon you, upon me, upon each one of us as we dwell in this land, so that we may be able to bring the glory of the Lord upon this land of Goa. Amen. Get ready, get prepared. Hallelujah. We believe that right now the coming revival to come upon our land of Goa. And you know what happens when revival comes? No man can stop, because the Spirit of God will be overtaking, and the powers of darkness will flee. Hallelujah. The harvest is ready, the Lord says, but He needs the laborers who will go out into the vineyard and to do His work. Amen. God is preparing His land. God is preparing His people. God is ready for a, you know, outpouring of His Spirit upon the land of Goa. And we as ambassadors of Christ, when we are available, when we say, yes Lord, here am I, what can I do? Lord, I know sometimes I'm getting bogged down with all these failures and sinful activities, but I want to look to the cross. I want to look to focus myself upon what Jesus has done, because He is the author, He is the perfecter of my faith. And as we get ready, we are a generation going out to take this land out of the darkness and spiritually to get it free from every sin, every slavery, every darkness, every shackle, to see God's purposes being fulfilled in the land of Goa. So I want to challenge you, I want to encourage you this day, get prepared. If you are discouraged, saying that what can I do, being in this small state, I can't do anything, but I want you to challenge you to say that you are not alone. God is with you. His Spirit is upon you. Get ready for that revival, because God is looking out for people who can go out, march in the name of Jesus, and get prepared for the revival. And the revival is here, and God is preparing His army. We need to be available. And when we look to God the Master, hallelujah, and He has called us, when we are faithful to our calling, to what He has called us, if He has planted you in a certain place, if He has planted you in this land for a purpose, hallelujah, get ready. Do not think about the small things which your mind is pulling you down. Think about what God has, hallelujah. Let that big picture open up your eyes and see the great vision. I want to thank God for your life. I want to thank God for your family. I want to thank God for the state of Goa, for all that God has blessed us with, and all the riches that He has blessed us with the beautiful state that He has blessed us with everything, all the people, the communities that He has blessed this land of Goa with. Let us not look down upon this land of Goa. Let us look to the opportunities, what we can do for Christ in this land. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, to see the revival will come upon our land, and we want to see every tongue will confess the name of the Lord, every knee shall bow down to the name of Jesus, and we want to and put forth our legs and our step and stepping in faith and believing that great revival is in store for us. And we want to see every kings, people of all authority, kings who are in authority, people of every community, people of every tribe, people of, you know, staying in near and far, they will come and worship the living God. And thus says the Lord, that, you know, that God will be pleased to see His people worshiping in spirit and in truth, to worship the living God. And that is our prayer this day, as we dedicate and as we thank God for the land of Goa to be, you know, that it's already liberated, and we have experienced the freedom. Truthfully, politically, we have experienced the freedom, but we want to see the spiritual freedom engulf the state of Goa. And let that be our prayer, and, you know, today and also in the days to come, that we want to see a generation rising up for God, a generation to see our next generation, our children and their future, so that they will see that this land will experience the true freedom in Christ. We want to see true freedom in every sense, so that they will be not engulfed with vices like alcoholism, drug addictions, prostitution, and every kind of such sin which is engulfing our young people, our children which are gone astray. We want to see them come, you know, worshiping God and coming and knowing who God is. Even our beautiful state, which is open for tourism, we want people to experience the power of God in this land of Goa. And let that be our prayer, this day and in the coming days. I want to pray, let Goa be filled with such riches and the glory of God. Let the presence of God come upon this land. So when the presence of God comes down, we will know the glory of God resides in this land. To know the true spiritual powers of darkness be broken. Amen. And we want to see that Goa rise up to the occasion of knowing the Lord Jesus, and let the banner of Jesus be flowing and, you know, mightily high upon this land of Goa. As I pray this prayer, and I want to dedicate this land in the name of Jesus, I want to pray for everyone, those who are listening to this message. I pray that God will challenge you, use you mightily in your homes, in your families. You know, wherever you are placed, you may be a young boy, a young girl, you may be just a student, you may be a homemaker, you may be a business person, you may be a person serving the Lord full-time, part-time, anyhow, I want to tell you that be encouraged. God has not given up on you. You are placed in this land. You are placed to, you know, to fulfill God's destiny. And as we celebrate the Liberation Day of Goa, I want to say that God has all His blessings and plans and purposes for this land of Goa. And for you, as you are placed in this place or wherever you are watching from right now, I want to pray that God will use you mightily in the land that you are living. Hallelujah. And as we celebrate the Liberation Day of Goa, let that true spirit of freedom, knowing about who Jesus is, let them be revealed to everyone, and God will influence you and make you an influencer to liberate many more people as you take that responsibility. Hallelujah. I pray that God will meet all your needs and fulfill the desire of your heart, and also fill you with the spirit of courage and boldness as you take charge of the responsibility that God will entrusted upon you to share the good news of who the living God is. Amen. Let the Lord lead you and make you a fruitful person as you know that, you know, in this day, that as Goa has been on this Liberation Day, I want to say that may the Lord use you mightily and your family and your children, so that we will be able to take charge of the responsibility to bring people out of darkness into this light. I bless you with the favor, with the anointing, and as we get prepared for the great revival that God has prepared for the land of Goa, Lord, let it come. Pour forth your revival upon Goa, and let the anointing of the Lord be upon this land. Let the glory of the land, glory of the Lord, you know, Lord, let it come upon Goa, so that, Lord, many eyes will be opened and will see the true light of Christ Jesus. I thank and praise you, Lord, for hearing all our prayers. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you. Thank you for hearing this message, and wish you a happy Liberation Day of Goa.